Hi guys, Dr. J here, and in this video we're going to talk briefly about how to load some data and visualize it in QGIS. Now, for most of the projects that we'll be doing, we'll probably just have point data, so that's the example that I'm going to go through with you here now. So I've already opened up QGIS for you guys. You'll be able to access QGIS in the computer labs through Apps Anywhere, so you can do it that way. QGIS is also free software, so you can also just download it on your own computer and use it there if you want. So I usually like to use the Openstreetmap Base Map. It's just, as you can see, a general map of the world, and that'll allow us to kind of see where our data is located. And then you can see that shows up in the layers down here. And then we're going to add a new layer. So I'm going to add a new layer. And the way this is going to work depends on the type of data that we're looking at. But in our case, in the case that I'm going to show you guys, we'll be just loading in a CSV file, .csv. And that's probably similar to a lot of the data that we'll be loading in during the course. So for that, I'm going to go to Add Delimited Text Layer here. And it's going to pop up with this dialog box. So I've got some magnetometry data from last year that was taken over at the Audubon Center. I'm going to open that up. Here we go. You can see the file format. This may be closed, the geometry definition, but you'll want to make sure to open that and make sure to select EPSG 4326 or WGS 84 as your coordinate system, your CRS, your coordinate reference system. And this goes back to what we talked about in the coordinate system videos and information, which is that we need to specify what coordinate system we're using for the data, or I should say, what coordinate system did we use when we actually went and collected the data. So if we had used a UTM coordinate system when we collected the data, some of our equipment is going to perhaps use UTM coordinates, then we would want to specify that here. Okay, so this is all looking good. Don't think I need to change any of these other fields. The values here, longitude, latitude, NT stands for nanotesla. We'll talk about this more later on in the course. And then I have the date and time that the measurement was taken. So I think all of that looks good. I'm going to hit add and then close. And you can see all my data is kind of showing up here in this little blip. So I want to zoom into that data. So an easy way to do that is just right click on your layer and then go zoom to layers. And I'll zoom out a little bit, but there we go. There's our Audubon Trails Nature Center that we'll be working at this semester. And here's the location of our magnetometry data. Now, you can notice a few things. One, it's a little bit, the dots are a little bit small, a little bit hard to see, and they're all the same color. And what I'd like to do is to color these dots by the magnetic intensity or the nanotesla that was measured at each one of the sites. So to do that, I'm just going to double click here. I'm going to come up here. I'm in the symbology tab. I'm going to come up here to single symbol, go to graduated, select my value is nanotesla. For the symbol, we'll just leave it at that as is for now. But we'll come here to color ramp, and I'm going to pick a color ramp, which I like. We can look at the histogram. And then I'm going to say, I'll just say equal intervals. So the values will be broken up into equal intervals. And you can adjust these if we need. We'll have 5 classes. Maybe we'll go to 6 classes. And let's see. I think we're good. I'm going to say OK. So there we go. The colors have now changed. And I am going to come over here and make those dots a little bit bigger. If I can do that, if I click on that symbol, I'm just going to come over here to size and make these dots a little bit bigger so they're a little easier to see. Okay, so now I can see my data. I could potentially take more data this year, include that here with this data, and we're going to do some of that, and we'll be able to put all of the data sets and different things that we come up with onto a single geographically referenced map like this. Okay, so that shows you just the very basics of how to get started putting some data into QGIS and looking at it, visualizing it. And that'll be all for now, and we'll talk more about this as we go along in the course if we need more details for certain types of data.